today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Welcome to Campus Sport and the University World Championships in futsal in Spain. We have the contrasting stories of two of the players in the tournament and also in the program, the University Beach Volleyball Worlds in Portugal. Plus, the Archery University Championships in Poland and wrestling from Hungary too. We start in the south of Spain, traveling from Malaga into the backcountry to Antequera, a medieval town famous for the walls and towers of its Moorish fortress. And this is the venue for the 14th World University Futsal Championships. 16 men's teams and 8 women's from around the world, with Malaga University in charge of the organization. It's our fourth World Championships here. It's the university's strategy, in fact, to launch the reputation of the university through sport. We're always working to increase our international academic excellence in different research studies, and for us, sport is an excellent skill. For some students, it's the only opportunity to travel around the world. Relationships built during the competitions can last forever.
The atmosphere here is really great. The local people, as well as the organizers, are so helpful. In our country, we're really anonymous, non-professional players. But here, well, we feel like we're playing in the Mundial, and it really feels great.
Among the women's teams, Brazil are outstanding. And in an outstanding team, they have one of the world's outstanding players.
Representing
my country, you know, it's always a big honor. It's a huge responsibility for me because a lot of girls are still back in Brazil. They wanted to come here and represent their country too. So for this reason, I'm very happy to wear the Brazil shirt and to try to defend our title in this World Championship. All the universities naturally want their best players for the tournament. It means they have to be flexible about the students' academic studies.
When I come this time, now in my university have exams, and now I'm here. When I'm back in Georgia, I must pass these exams.
Something of a shock for the Spanish fans, the defeat of their men in the quarterfinals, but their misery spelled joy for Belarusia. The university is doing a lot to help the athletes. Athletes get scholarships from the university and are allowed to have alternative examination dates, and that really does support them. This was the end of the road for the Portuguese women, eliminated in the quarterfinal by those Brazilians. Here's one of the losers, far from disheartened though, buoyed up by the support she gets. I'm at the University of Minho, and they make a lot of effort to maintain a high standard of the students through sports and studies. They're doing some excellent work. There's a real balance to integrate the students in both these spheres. It really is a symbiosis. In the men's competition, the Iranians would make the semi-finals, helped by goals like this. Assad University has helped me to go to the championships, not only in Iran, but to come here to the World Championships too. And that's the way they helped me. Iran will face Belarus in the match for the bronze medal. Sadly, the Belarusians just a little bit too strong. They would get the bronze. In the women's semi-finals, Brazil went through, while Spain, the home nation, meant Russia, finally prevailing, setting up a final against the defending champions. I know I can't earn a living from football, but I can do if I become a doctor later. I want to progress in my medical studies now. I want to be a surgeon, and that demands a lot of time to study. So futsal has become a hobby. I don't want to stop football because it's my life too, but at this moment, it's only my hobby. The atmosphere in the Spanish team, very relaxed before the final. They are at home, and they're confident. Meanwhile, the Brazilian coaches have their final briefing. Brazil have been University World Champions three times in a row, and they don't want to let that trophy go. To be far from your country can make you sad, you know, because we're not at home most of the time. Today, futsal is my life. I can live from it, and I can help my family thanks to futsal. They understand, so they can accept the separation and the distance better. But without their tenderness and attention, we miss our mothers and fathers. So by force of circumstance, really, futsal becomes our family. So in the final, despite the Spanish confidence, the Brazilian team would duly win the score 3-1 to become University World Champions for the fourth time running. Spain got the silver, Russia the bronze. And the celebrations went on with Vanessa Pereira on the winning side once more. The Russian men relax at their hotel before their final against Brazil, who are favorites for the gold, just like the women were. The Brazilians also tried to keep their nerves at bay, distracting themselves with their telephones before the intensity of the final to come.
Força Brasil!
The Fernando Arguelles sports venue full of passionate spectators in the first half. Brazil on top. They build a lead of 3-0. Second half, though, different story. They started to make mistakes, and the Russians took full advantage. It really was a tale of two halves. The final score was 8-5 in the Russians' favor. The World University Futsal Championships in Spain. You're watching Campus Sport. In the second part of the program, we hear the stories of two of the futsal players involved in those university worlds as we meet Denise and Enrique. And we'll travel to Porto in Portugal for the Beach Volleyball World University Championships. Stay with us.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student-athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
In Malaga, during the University Futsal Championships, a chance to meet two of the players and hear the stories of their university life and their chosen sport. Denise is from Uruguay, a student in economics. But for her, this World Championship was a big opportunity to live her passion for football to the full. Enrique is a professional player from further up the coast in Spain, in Murcia. He's studying business sport management. His university provides him with all the advantages of a top-level athlete. First, let's hear from Denise Irigoyen. This is my first and my last World Championship. Such a pity, really, that it's the last, because it was so wonderful to take part. Finally, I got the opportunity to do it one time in my life, to discover the human aspects of other cultures here. Really was fantastic. It was incredible to arrive at the hotel, to share things with the other delegations, other cultures, other countries. It was a very interesting human adventure to live together for 10 or 12 days. It was perfect because the group was very nice. The understanding was amazing. We became friends with people you couldn't meet in other situations, thanks to the University World Championships. Sharing daily life with other nationalities is so cool, so cool. We paid all the expenses for our trip. Plane tickets, accommodation, food, everything was down to ourselves. UCAM University in Murcia helps the students so much with the scholarships. We play under the university name and they get the credit. This year, UCAM won the title Best University in Spain. I need to work. I study and I play futsal. Unfortunately, the fact that I'm obliged to work and play football, and of course I play because it's my passion, well, it's all caused a delay in my studies. My career is being slowed down somewhat. But at the end of the day, my wish is to finish my studies as soon as possible.
La carrera lo antes posible, ¿no?
I'm really disciplined in my studies. Even if the professors help you, you need to be really organized. You can miss some classes, but during the exams, we're all students, all of us, facing the same tests.
El fútbol femenino ha crecido.
Women's futsal is growing very slowly, I think. The women don't have the same support as men do. I know here it's not like that, but in my country, in Uruguay, well, you can find people who don't even know that women's football exists.
No sé aquí, pero allá quizá hay gente que no sabe que hay fútbol femenino.
FISU, the International Federation of University Sports, is aware of the issue of gender equality, and women's disciplines were included in their sports program at a very early stage. We're very lucky, really, because the FISU World Championships are for men and women. So we can come to watch the women's matches, to cheer for them, because they study at the university like us, and we have the chance of supporting them while they do the same for us. As a woman, I ask FISU to continue to support women's sport, to continue with this kind of sport. I hope they can put pressure on my country and invest more and more. What I saw in this tournament is that we are the underprivileged ones in all aspects, in terms of the standard of our sport. And also, economically, we are very far behind the other teams. My dream is that futsal will be in the next Summer Universiade and will soon be in the Olympic Games, to give futsal a little corner in the Olympics.
Su rinconcito dentro de la Olimpiada.
Located along the Douro River estuary in northern Portugal, Porto is one of the oldest European cities, its center designated as a World Heritage Site. But this summer, it's all about another world, the World University Championships in beach volleyball. 58 teams taking part altogether, 32 men's, 26 women's from 26 countries. Over the years, we've built extraordinary skills to be able to stage this tournament. We have the support of the university, the sporting university programs, and the support of the government. Portugal is a perfect place for this FISU university competition. Playing against Solvoll and Lunde of Norway, the Americans winning by 2-1. So it was the USA against Germany for the beach volleyball title. And the USA coming out the winners, 2-0. In the men's semi-finals, some terrific play, and really all four teams deserve to be in the final. However, there's only room for two, and Holler and Schroeder of Germany took the win over Brazil's first team by 2-0. Poland won, beating the Austrians, Dressler and Kuna, 2-1. The Austrians would beat the Brazilians to take the bronze medal. For the final, expectations were high and the teams didn't let anyone down. With a full stadium, the spectators were treated to a cracking game. In the end, Germany would beat the Polish duo by 2-0. And then, as the teams were presented with their medals, gold for USA and Germany, the FISU flag would be passed from the Portuguese to the Estonian delegation, the organizing country of the next World University Championships in beach volleyball in 2016. This is Campus Sport, and in part three, we'll travel to Lenica in Poland for the Archery World Championships. And then to Hungary and Pécs for a little bit of wrestling.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade. The home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
The 10th World University Archery Championships have been taking place in Poland. And here in Lenica, a record number of competitors, more than ever before in the history of the competition, with 206 student athletes. FISU's technical chairman here was the 1992 Olympic champion Juan Carlos Holgado, looking forward to the competition.
As an athlete, top athlete I have been, and in my position as World Archery Event Director, I can tell you this, the event is in a high standard.
Once again, though, it's not just about sport. A bronze medalist with the Americans in the compound women's team competition, this is Jackson Hunter.
This championship for me means an opportunity to not only represent my country, but also my school, and an opportunity to get to know other archers from around the world that I wouldn't have had the chance to meet before.
Archers fought in 10 finals, Korea dominating the medal table with 4 golds. But in the women's individual compound, it was the Italian, Katia D'Agostino, who took the title, beating the Mexican, Stephanie Salinas Pereira. Sena Toya from Slovenia took the bronze and was pretty happy about it.
It's another great experience for me. Actually, I can see that my work is good, so I will continue with shooting.
Ukraine's Vladislav Bolshakov stayed focused in the tense men's compound event, beating the favorite Kim Jong-ho and Daniel Gregory of the United States. Yating of Chinese Taipei took gold in the recurve final ahead of two Koreans, Shin Jong-hwa and Jong Hun-yong. Luis Antonio Alvarez Morillo of Mexico was already a silver medalist in the recurve mixed team event. Now he struck gold in the individual competition. And he aims to defend his title in 2016 in Mongolia. Here's the Mongolian representative.
Really invited many countries. And this is must be one is a big test event and Rio de Janeiro Olympic Games. Also, Mongolia is a very long time history, national archery. Then our archery family like to come and see Mongolian national archery and history of Mongolia.
These World University Championships will be the last because archery will be included in the compulsory sports program of the Summer Universiad, the University Games, in 2019. This is Pécs, the fifth largest city in Hungary, located in the southwest of the country. Just the place for the 11th World University Championships in wrestling. 8 weight categories for the men and for the women. Hungary has plenty of experience in organizing major wrestling championships, and FISA was happy that the competitors could benefit from this experience once again.
This particular championship, we have about 280 participants coming from 30 countries. We have over 100 volunteers and organizing committee running around putting this event together. And it's been very successful so far.
And here in the city of wrestling, the university wrestlers showing a pretty high level of performance and certainly showing a lot of ambition. One of the rising stars from the USA is Patrick Smith.
For me, it was a great experience. It was my first world team experience. So it was great for me to be able to represent my country and compete against some of the best athletes in the world.
Patrick competes for the University of Minneapolis in the 71 kilogram category. Here in Pécs, in the Greco-Roman semifinals, he beat the Japanese wrestler Nakamura 9-7. But he was defeated in the final by the local hero, Tamás Lorincz. Lorincz, the 2012 Olympic silver medalist and 3 times European champion. This was my first time at the World University Championships, and I know it's going to be my last time too because the age limit is 28. The next time, I won't be able to compete, so it's very important for me that I won this medal. Unfortunately, the competition wasn't as strong as I expected, but it was still a good competition. Lorincz wasn't the only successful Hungarian. In the 66-kilogram category, gold went to Christian Jäger, upsetting the Turk Abdul Samet Gunal. In the 75-kilogram category, another Hungarian, Laszlo Szabo, took the gold. He beat the Ukrainian Oleksandr Kuktar. Moving up the weights, 98 kilograms, and the local fans standing up and cheering for yet another Hungarian champion. This time it was Ivan Nemet beating Mahmut Alkan of Turkey 6-0. And going up the weights, the 130-kilogram category this time, again it was Hungary, Balint Lam taking the gold against Ismail Guzel. Altogether, a great boost for Hungarian university sports.
University sport is becoming more and more important in Hungary. So I'm quite old enough to remember that, let's say, 30, 40 years ago, the university teams were in basketball, in water polo, and in every other sport, very important, and champions of Hungary, you know. And somehow this faded. But we hope that events like this, you know, so can bring back for the students these old feelings, you know, and probably, well, we can build teams which will become champions, you know.
In Pécs then, for Hungary, four individual men's medals plus the team gold, with Turkey in second place and Poland in third. Finally, a brief word on the handball at Guimarães in Portugal. In the men's competition, the Portuguese squad made the local fans very happy, taking the World University title. Portugal were up against their cousins from Brazil. The Europeans almost always ahead on the scoreboard, despite some good spells from the South Americans, and eventually winning by 29-23 to take that trophy. Their first University World Championship title. Brazil won the women's gold medal. They beat Russia in the final, 24-17. And that just about wraps it up for this time. Campus Sport, the magazine devoted to the best of university sport, will be back with the next edition on September the 24th. Until then.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.